My name is Merrick Gertler, and it is my great privilege to serve the University of Toronto as its 16th president. Today, I have the additional privilege of assisting Chancellor Rose Patton in conducting this special honorary degree ceremony. I bid a warm welcome to everyone who has joined us virtually from around the globe. In compliance with public health directives in the province of Ontario to help stop the spread of COVID-19, we are conferring all honorary degrees virtually. In normal times, this ceremony would have occurred during a convocation ceremony, where we gather in person to celebrate the achievements of our U of T graduates and our honorary degree recipients together. And so I'd like to thank our honorary graduate, Dr. Anne Innis Dagg, for agreeing to accept the University of Toronto's highest honor under these unique circumstances. I would also like to thank Ms. Mary Dagg for agreeing to serve as hooder, an important ceremonial role in the conferral portion of the convocation ceremony. It is now my great honor to present Dr. Anne Innis Dagg. Anne Innis Dagg is renowned both for her groundbreaking work in the field of animal behavior and ecology, and for her advocacy on behalf of women in science. She is a generous mentor, a compelling role model, and a robust example of what the best of Canadian ingenuity and perseverance can achieve. After earning her undergraduate and master's degrees from the University of Toronto, graduating with a gold medal in biology, Dr. Dagg traveled to South Africa to pursue research on giraffes without the benefit of university backing or funding. She is widely considered to be the founder of giraffe science and a true pioneer in the field of zoology. She was not only the first scholar to study giraffe behavior in the wild, but also the first to study any wild animal behavior in Africa, preceding her famous contemporary Jane Goodall by several years. She is also a champion for the rights of women in the academy, drawing on her own experiences to highlight the unique obstacles facing female scholars and to inform her fight for gender equality. Despite lacking the institutional support that would have facilitated her research, Dr. Dagg has written more than 60 refereed articles and over 20 books, including The Giraffe, Its Biology, Behavior, and Ecology, which quickly became the most influential book on the species ever written. Her accomplishments in animal behavioral ecology have earned her lifetime achievement awards from both professional and academic organizations. Over the past few years, Dr. Dagg has also begun to receive long-deserved media attention, most recently in the globally successful feature film, The Woman Who Loves Giraffes, which chronicles her career and achievements. Now, in the later stages of her career, Dr. Dagg remains deeply committed to conservation efforts in Africa, having helped to establish Save the Giraffes. For her outstanding service for the public good, as a trailblazing scientist and a passionate advocate for equity in academia, Chancellor Patton, on behalf of the Governing Council, I ask you to confer the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, upon Anne Innis Dagg.
On behalf of the University of Toronto and by virtue of the authority vested in me, I have the great honor and pleasure of conferring on you, Anne Innis Dagg, the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa.
As the newest member of the University of Toronto alumni, Dr. Dagg, I extend warmest congratulations on behalf of the entire U of T community. I now invite you to deliver your address.
Dear students, faculty, and honored guests, I am pleased to be receiving this honorary degree from the University of Toronto. My ties to this university run deep. My father, Harold Innis, was chair of the economics department and had a college named after him. My mother, Mary Quill Innis, was Dean of Women at University College for 9 years, and I graduated with a master's degree in zoology. I inherited my parents' passion for education and learning, and I've spent my life pursuing the understanding of animal behavior, especially of giraffes. I traveled to South Africa in the 1950s at the age of 23, before anyone else had made such an attempt. However, as many of you will know, of course, my career was sidetracked by the institutional sexism that was rampant in academia. Despite my scientific accomplishments and teaching record, three different Ontario universities discriminated against me because I was a woman. At the time, I fought back and took my case to the Ontario Supreme Court. Something tells me if that were to happen today, I would have a lot of you on my side. We would have demanded the chance that I now started to see in our society. Despite having to live with these overwhelming setbacks, I've written 32 books and 60 scientific articles. I've been recognized with honors such as this one today. I've received the Order of Canada, and an award-winning documentary was made about me, my life, the woman who loves giraffes. Looking back over my life experiences, there are two key messages I would like to offer you. First, never stop learning. The degrees you earn today are just the first step in a long journey ahead of listening and reading and writing and watching and thinking, the points on a compass that lead to fulfillment. Secondly, keep pushing. You will be faced with many challenges that will prevent you from reaching your goals. Find another way. Reach out to others who will help you. Look for those mentors who will bring out your best and shine. Finally, be kind to nature and the animals with whom we share the world. It is my everlasting hope that people will treat animals and the environment with the same respect as we treat each other. Congratulations and long live giraffes.
Thank you, Dr. Anne Innis Dagg. And let me say, you have inspired us with your lifetime career and accomplishments. And today, you have inspired us with your words. We are delighted to count you among the most distinguished members of our alumni community. And in closing, I offer warm congratulations to you and all the graduates of 2021.